So, hey, hello, and welcome to the 3rd of August, which is coincidentally is going to be the day I hope that I start the Newts Readathon. And this is the vlog for the Newts Readathon. I am incredibly tired because I've been packing. I'm gonna make a trip to Italy for the next week, so great time to be doing a readathon, but yeah. And I just came here fairly quick because I have to go finish the packing to tell you guys that I made some changes in my Nudes TBR. So I'm going to leave a link down below to the vlog, my Nudes TBR, so that you guys can check it first and then see the changes that I made. But I'm gonna go ahead and talk to you about those. So the first one that I did was for charms. For the Outstanding in Charms, instead of reading the first volume of A Silent Voice, I'm gonna be reading the third volume of Happiness by Shuzo Shimi, because shit is hitting the fans in the second volume, so probably this one will leave a mark. This is like this manga series about this guy that he's a student, he's bullied, but then he gets turned into a vampire by this girl, and he just, I don't know, bad things start happening, good things as well, but mostly bad things, and I think that it's going to leave a mark. I am loving the art style and also loving the story, so I really want to continue. And then for the Exceeding Expectations in Transfiguration, which is author you haven't read anything before, I decided to change the manga that I chose to Happiness Volume 4. Why? Because this author, Shuzo Shimi, has another series that he or she, like, I'm not sure, I should have seen if it was a he or a she, but whatever, that the author did before this series called Flowers of Evil. And although I have the third omnibus volume, I don't have the first or the second, and I haven't started that series, I haven't read it. So this is the first actual series that I'm reading by this author, although the author has another work, and hence why I'm considering that I haven't read anything else by this author except this work, because I'm considering it like a book of sorts, okay? So these two I'm changing, and then I'm changing the first one for potions, so the acceptable for potions, which it is name of a color in the title, I believe. Book with the name of a color. And I was going to read a book that was plus 400 and something pages. I believe it was 500. So I decided to change that to some comic volumes. And I promise that I'm going to read the eighth volumes that compile this series, but I am going to read the White Knight series, the Batman White Knight series. And this is by Sean Murphy and Matt Hollingsworth. And this is basically kind of a story like if the Joker, I don't know if you know the Joker, but he's one of the most famous villain Batmans and also one of my favorite villain crushes, so obviously I wanted to read this. And this is basically if he got sane, because supposedly he's insane, but we'll never know if he actually is or isn't. And so what if he got sane? What if he pressed charges against Batman because Batman mistreated him? Just because he was insane, like he had a disease, a psychological disease. So then, for what I know, like I haven't read it yet, so don't come at me, comic fans, but for what I know, supposedly the Joker becomes sane and he kind of pressed charges against Batman and he became the savior of Gotham, so the White Knight, because Batman is the Dark Knight. So something like that. There are only eight volumes in the series, so I'm going to read the eighth volume so that I can consider it like and 100 and something pages book so that I can replace this, because with me going on vacation and with everything happened this month, my thesis and everything, I am not sure that I will have the time that I need to pass all of my five thingies if I don't change this. So I decided to do it and I did it. That's gonna be that. And now I have to go, so I hope that you guys enjoyed this little bit of a thingy. I hope that you don't get too upset with me. I'm not even sure what I'm saying right now. I look gross because it's really warm here in Portugal and I'm sweating and I have to take a shower. Oh, gross. But yeah, I'm gonna see if I can read something today, but if I don't, I'll probably just read in my vacations. I don't know if I'm going to vlog in my vacations. Maybe I can insert some clips of me reading or something. I hope hope so, but if I don't, please don't get sad. I will film the rest of the weeks, I promise, but this is just how it's gonna go. I'm very, very sorry, but yeah, so getting ready for vacations. It is me. Long time no see slash speaking slash anything, because as I told you probably in the first clip of this vlog, I went on vacation to Italy, so I couldn't film much. I took a book to read, but I'm gonna go there in a second. But I couldn't do a lot of vloggish stuff, so I decided that I was probably just going to accumulate some clips for the entire, like, first 2 weeks of August, and just do part one of the vlog and then part two after the 15th, so until the end of August. And probably the second part is going to be way longer than the first one, because I don't have a lot of clips for the first one. So yeah, that's just gonna be it. It's not going to be the same as I did in my owls with one vlog each week, because sadly I can't, because I wasn't here. So enough with the apologizing. I want to give you some news. So as you've probably seen on some of my clips, I was reading, when I went to Italy, I took The Constant Garden by Jean Le Carré to read, and that was going to be my outstanding for History of Magic, so a book with at least 400 pages, I believe. But obviously you can't get your outstanding without getting an acceptable and an exceeding expectation. So what I did was I took that book to Italy, because that book was 437 pages, and I still haven't finished it, so I'm currently reading it. Why? Because I took it to Italy to just, I knew I wouldn't be able to read
as much as I wanted when I was there because my priorities were other, like catching some sun, being with my mom, just knowing new things. So I just took it, and I could only take a book, so I decided to take that one because it was the biggest on my TBR for the nudes. So I took that one, and I read approximately almost 300 pages of the book. So I reached chapter 17, and then I stopped because I arrived in Portugal again. So what I did was I started reading A Room of One's Own by Virginia Woolf, and that was my book for the acceptable in History of Magic. It was a book that you believe would fit right in at Hogwarts. And I, at the time, I said that I believed that because it was fairly yellow, it looked ancient, and it was a book about Muggle feminism, so probably even for non-Muggle-born witches, they would probably would want to know something about the subject, and it was small, and I believe it would fit right in at Hogwarts. But now, after reading it, I believe it even more because it's not only like a feminist book about women in our society since the beginning of time. It is also a proposition to all of women to do what they can to write, to work, to be professionals in their area of work, to make way to other women to be able to do other things. And it was like a cry for action, and I believe that for witches everywhere that will be amazing to just act, and it will be as important in Hogwarts and in the wizarding world as it is in our world. So yeah, but I finished this already, so I have my acceptable in History of Magic, and I progressed today to Chronicle of a Death Foretold by Gabriel Garcia Marquez, which was my exceeding expectation for History of Magic as well. And that was a book that was published at least 5 years ago, but this book was published, as I said, when I did my TBR. Let me see if I can remember it correctly. Well, I'm just gonna look because I don't remember. This was published in 1981 in the original edition and in 1995 in the Portuguese edition of this printer. So obviously it's way more than 5 years ago, but I wanted to read it. It was fairly small and I finished it in one day, so I already have my exceeding expectations for History of Magic, and I loved it. It's beautiful. It is the story of basically this little village where everyone knows that this dude is going to be murdered by the brothers of this girl because she got married and her husband returned her to her house in the wedding night because she wasn't a virgin. So it was this big shame, and she decided to blame it on this guy, and it wasn't his fault, but nobody knew that it wasn't his fault. So her brothers decided to avenge her honor, basically. And so they started telling everyone because they really didn't want to kill this dude, but they felt like it was their social obligation to do it. They started to tell everyone that they were going to kill the man. And yeah, it's the story of how a death that was so foretold actually happened, because you would think that if someone told you, "I'm going to kill that dude," you would do anything in your power to prevent it. But in society, it's not really quite that easy or quite that the action that you will have. And it was fairly amazing. It was a social criticism, obviously, but it was also magical realism, so it was freaking awesome. I really love Gabriel Garcia Marquez. I read three of his other books, and I enjoyed all of them. So I'm in a great path to know this writer and to love his works. And now I am currently reading The Constant Gardener, and I am already at 350 something pages, so maybe today I'll finish it because I have less than 100 pages to read, so probably I can finish it. And I would love to, because I want to have a no in my History of Magic. I always found History of Magic pretty amazing, which people might think it's tedious because it's kind of, it's History of Magic, like, why would you care? It's very theoretical, but I always thought that I would like to learn about History of Magic. So enough about that. That is going to be my first need to be fulfilled, I believe. I don't know if I'm going to read some comics or some manga today. I don't know. I'm just gonna film something if I will. And that's enough for my update. So I hope that you understand all of the gymnastics that I've been doing to be able to read a book that I wasn't supposed to read and then read the other two books, but just, it is just, whew. So currently I have two books down, and let the readathon commence, because basically I didn't commence my readathon until the 13th. So I know that I read some pages before, but it doesn't count, okay people? It doesn't count. And yeah, I will see you in a new update someday.
Hello, and welcome to day 15 of August and 15th day of the readathon. And I can't stay here very long. I am actually working on my thesis, and I am editing a little bit of this vlog to see if I can get it up this week. And I just came here to say that I finished The Constant Garden by Jean Le Carré, and I really enjoyed it. This is kind of a sort of a spy story about this girl. She is killed for trying to reveal some secrets of the pharmaceutical industries in Kenya. And her husband, a much older man than she is, that worked in the Foreign Office in Africa for the British consulate, that decides to retrace her steps and try to find out the truth and punish those that killed her and that wronged her and bring the truth forward. And it was pretty cool. I wasn't expecting enjoying a spy book so much, because I like those kind of books, but I prefer like just watching movies like James Bond or something, and it's not really my type of writing and my type of plots, but it was fairly enjoyable. Oh, my phone was going down. A little bit political. It was very, very interesting from a political and social point of view, and I really enjoyed it. So at this moment, I finally finished History of Magic, so I got an O in History of Magic, because this was my book for the O, and it was a book at least 400 pages long. This book was 434 pages long, so it is done, and I am so happy about this. So I'm gonna move forward to another course, another challenge, and I have no idea what that will be, so I will check with you later when I figure that out. Hello and welcome again. So I was doing some thesis work, and then I was gonna go to the pool to catch some sun, but I'm having horrible cramps, which is probably too much information for all of you, but yeah, I decided to give it to you. So yeah, I am having terrible cramps. I don't want a lot of warmth, and I already changed my pajamas. I was in a t-shirt, and now I am not in a t-shirt. I'm in a tank top and shorts because it was too hot. I really react badly to extreme weather, like too hot or too cold, when I am in this physical condition. So I decided to just stay home, and I finished the work that I had planned for today for my thesis. I painted my nails from my hands and my feet. And I decided that I am going to start my potions acceptance challenge, which is read the book with the name of a color in the title. I'm sorry if I look a little bit off, because I'm actually off. I already took 2 pills for pain, and they are now working. Isn't that amazingly awesome? So I'm gonna show you the book that I'm going to read for that one, if you haven't seen my TBR, and then I'm just gonna read a little bit, because I have to leave home. It's currently 5, no, it's not yet 5, it's 5:15 currently, and I have to leave the house like at 6 or 6:15 to go meet up with my boyfriend, because supposedly we're going with him and some of his friends to watch Ant-Man and the Wasp today, because it is a release date for Ant-Man and the Wasp. But I know that everyone out there has already seen it, except for me, but I'm cool with that. I am not the biggest Ant-Man fan in the world. Like, I enjoy superheroes, but Ant-Man is not my jam at all. So I'm just gonna see it because it's going to be fun, and we're going with the guys and the girls probably, and yeah, everything, so that's gonna be fun. So yeah, I'm just gonna show you what I'm gonna read for my potions except I don't remember what the first grade is, like, I don't care. It's I know that's exceeding expectations and then outstanding acceptable. Yeah, oh god, I am so dumb today. Thank you. and I am here with a new update because I haven't said anything since yesterday. So yeah, today is August 16th, so it's the 16th day of the Newts Readathon, and currently I have a no in History of Magic, so I read my three books for History of Magic, my hardest subject to pass, and I did, and I started my acceptable for potions, which, if you don't recall, I changed it, and it is the 8th volumes of the Batman the White Knight comic. So I already read three of them, and I'm in the middle of the fourth one, which I hope to finish today, this evening, probably. I hope to finish all of The White Knight today because I am loving it. It's about the Joker, so it's great. And I decided to start my acceptable for Transfiguration, which was a book with a gray cover. So I didn't have a totally gray cover, but I have this one. It is Of Love and Shadow by Isabel Allende, and I decided to start it because it's only 241 pages, and it's fairly small. I started this 3 hours ago. Well, no, 2 hours ago. No, what time is it? I don't know. Actually, it was only 1 hour ago. Okay, I am off on my time. But yeah, I started this 1 hour ago, and I read 46 pages, so I think this is going to be done, if not by today, probably by the end of this week, like in the weekend or something. And I want to get this over with because, not counting this one, I only have one actual book remaining for the readathon, and the rest is only manga series and comics, so it's way easier to finish. So I really want to get this over with. And this sounds really amazing. It's kind of a love story between two people that shouldn't be in love, and it's where is this actually? I actually don't think she does a setting for this, but I think this is probably in Peru or something, because she was born in Peru. So maybe, I don't know. I have no idea. But yeah, so it's kind of a love story, but fairly political, and very, like, it talks about social prejudice, and refugees, and mental illness, and how that is portrayed in society, and it's really cool. It was published a fairly long time ago, in 1984, so we have to remind ourselves that society is not really the same, but for what I've read, some of the prejudice and some of the stuff that is explored in here, it's fairly similar, which is kind of scary and also kind of sad if you want to know about that, but yeah, that's what I feel. Also, I did went to see Ant-Man and the Wasp yesterday, and I was really shocked at how much I laugh at it, because it was pretty cool, and I wasn't expecting it, because Ant-Man is not actually my favorite superhero. I'm sorry if I'm offending someone, but it's not, and I wasn't even with higher expectations to watch the movie, but I really enjoyed it. It was pretty cool. Funnier than the first one, probably, but I don't know about the whole plot scene. I think the first one was better in terms of plot, but the second one was better in terms of funny moments. Like, I don't know, I don't know, but I really enjoyed out the ending scene tied with Avengers Infinity War. That was amazing, I really loved it, and I can't wait for the next Avengers.